the News 8 Storm Team Forecast with meteorologist Matt Moore.
Oh, you are looking live here in York. Yeah, the water droplets on the lens there. It is definitely raining in York right now, and other locations of the Susquehanna Valley, seeing some showers moving on through. But if you live north of the Turnpike, you probably haven't seen much in the way of showers. Just kind of an overcast, gloomy day to start off your Friday and your Friday morning. But we are expecting some showers to move on into the region as we go into the afternoon. York right now, it's 71 degrees. Now, that dew point in the mid-60s despite the rain. So we are seeing a little bit lower dew points than what we've been seeing the past couple of days. But certainly, the rain is here, especially in York and Lancaster counties here. And just to the south of the Turnpike, now in Franklin and Adams counties earlier this morning, we're seeing the rain, but that since has dried down and seen some heavier showers as you go towards southern Lancaster County, southern York County, and it was even heavier as it was in Chester County, but it looks like it's starting to fall apart. However, we are expecting it to fill in as we go through the rest of the afternoon, and because of that, the National Weather Service has issued these flash flood watches for the potential of seeing some heavier downpours, especially in the locations that are highlighted in blue, and yes, this does include Chester County, including Coatesville, and for portions farther to the east. So just watch out if you live in those areas for some of those heavier downpours. So your News 8 Storm Team forecast for today, expect the cloudy, gloomy conditions to continue. Scattered showers are expected pretty much all day today, and it will be a little bit cooler. The clouds, they're going to keep temperatures from really getting out of the 70s today. In fact, we'll be probably in the upper 70s for highs. Tonight, we'll drop down into the upper 60s, mostly cloudy skies with a few showers around. Not as widespread as what we will see today. We should start to see that shower activity dying down. And that will take us into tomorrow, and it will be a mostly cloudy day, I think, for at least the majority of the day, but we will break out into some sunshine during the afternoon with the chance for a couple of isolated showers, and temperatures will rise up into the low 80s. So overall, it's not actually going to be that bad of a day when the sun breaks out. But right now, we're looking at satellite radar across the eastern half of the United States. See a whole lot of nothing going on around Chicago, St. Louis. High pressure building in. Tropical storm, or what's left of Tropical Storm Chantal, is spinning down here in the Bahamas, and this will interact with a frontal boundary that's resting right along the coast. Should not bring any impacts to any coastal areas across the mid-Atlantic, but this system will. It's a developing surface low right around Washington, D.C., and that's bringing that moisture back around it. And so as we go throughout the rest of the afternoon, the radar will fill in, and we can see that here on predictor as we go into this afternoon. Brings all of that precipitation north of the Turnpike, farther to the west as well, and then before it spins around and basically falls apart. So as we go into tomorrow morning, it does look like it dries out just a little bit before more showers pop up during the afternoon. A little bit of sun trying to break out there, and that takes us into Sunday. Clouds in the morning breaking out into the sun, and maybe a couple of stray showers or storms possible as we go into Sunday afternoon. But after that, the heat is on. In fact, we bring back the 90s. Going into next week, and it does look like we have the chance for some showers and storms each day. By Wednesday, we could be making a run at the middle 90s, so the heat is back.